Hey, welcome to Show and Tell with the Two Mortgage Guys. We come to you every Tuesday live on Facebook and YouTube. And today we're interviewing Mindy Heady, Howard County Assessor. She's going to be sharing some information on property taxes, how they're calculated, and what we can do to try to save some money. Don't go anywhere.
So Mindy was born and raised in Kokomo. She's been married to her husband, Bill, for 34 years. She started working in the Howard County Treasurer's Office in 2005 and became Chief Deputy Treasurer in 2007. She began working in the Assessor's Office in 2010 and became the Howard County Assessor in 2014. She's a Level 3 Certified Indiana Assessor Appraiser, and she knows a thing or two about property values and Indiana tax law. Let's welcome to the show Mindy Heady.
Hey, Mindy.
Mindy, thanks so much. Yes, yeah, so exactly what Steve's going to say. Thanks so much for taking time to come on the show. We were really looking forward to this one because we feel like this is a subject matter that most people have no idea how their property taxes are calculated and what they're doing to impact those. And there's just so many things we can kind of talk about and educate people on today.
Of course. Looking forward to it.
Well, I'm going to fire away some questions, and so is Steve, and by all means, if there's something you feel like we haven't covered that we need to talk about, let us know. But I guess from the standpoint of taxation on real estate, you know, what's one of the biggest mistakes you see people making that impact their tax amounts and like what they owe?
Yeah, there's a couple things on that. I think the most important thing is to make sure people have filed the deductions that they qualify for. The homestead specifically is the biggest impact. And there's just so many, but those are filed in the auditor's office, and there's so many you can do. Homestead is the biggest one. There's an age deduction. There is a veterans deduction, heritage barn. I mean, there's too many to list, but that is the biggest thing I would say.
And you can pick that information up. Is that something that somebody can go to the website and they can look at, like, the forms? We know, like, when we go to a closing, the title companies give them the information on the sheet with all the different deductions. But can somebody just get that?
Yeah, I think if you go to the Howard County website and then click on the auditor is where you'd get that information.
Okay.
Because one thing I wanted to say is a lot of people say exemptions and deduction, they use those interchangeably and they're different, right? So exemptions, or people that want to file a Form 136 in my office, and that's handled in my office. If you're trying for like educational exemption or religious exemption, like churches, so they don't even get taxed at all. Whereas the deductions are filed in the auditor's office to reduce their tax liability.
Good. That was something I was going to ask about, because the words get interchanged a lot in our industry. They just say, people say, hey, make sure you go get your exemption filed. Right. And it's really a deduction, not anything.
Right. Yes.
So churches, and what's the other most common one for a tax exempt?
So people will file for charities, educational, like the schools.
Yeah. Okay. That makes sense. But your average homeowner is not exempt.
Right.
They're getting deductions to reduce their tax amount.
Right. So they're going to want to be an auditor for those.
Right. Now, I've always kind of told the story this way. Tell me if I'm saying this right, for the last 18 years. taxation on property, the maximum is 3% of the assessed value. And that would be like a commercial property.
Correct.
2% for an investment property, a property that you don't live in, something maybe that you're renting out, or a home you bought to flip. And then 1% for primary residence.
Right. So my office, the assessor's office, we put the structures and items that are being assessed, we put them in a certain cap. So we'll put every home in a 1%. So you get your home up to 1 acre and one garage in 1%. And then extra items around the house, a pool, a shed, a second garage, those are all 3% cap. And like I said, once they go to the auditor, if they see that they don't have a homestead on that property, then they would move that to a 2% cap.
Okay. Now, things like you mentioned a swimming pool, so you're going to get taxed higher on a swimming pool. It's also the concrete around it, like any concrete on a property?
Yes.
Yep. And then what about, like, is there a difference between a deck if it's attached to the home versus like, somewhere else on the property.
Right. So some houses are built and their patios are attached, and those would be in the 1% cap. But like when you go adding a pool and then the concrete and then an extra patio, and it may butt up to it, but it still came later, that would be a 3% cap because it's really part of the pool. On a good note, some things we don't assess are driveways for residentials, right?
Okay.
This is for not commercial, just for residents, right? We don't assess their driveway or like the kids' playhouse or fences residentially. We don't pick those up.
Right.
So a playhouse, not so much, but a shed.
Yep.
Would be. So like a she shed, that's a big thing, right? People putting sheds in their backyards and those are getting taxed at 3%.
3%.
Okay. And then.
Go ahead.
I think there was something about if you have a detached garage, but it's your only garage, it's 1%.
Correct.
But if it's an addition.
Yep. One garage is 1%, whether it's attached or detached.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Hey, that spurred me. I had a bunch of questions written down, Tammy and Ryan, Mindy and Ryan shot all those out right there. I had them all down with what I had on it. So
right.
I can start back over with where I'm trying to think at. One of the pieces then when you're doing that with the add-on, so if somebody sometimes says, hey, I think my square footage is off, who do they talk to? Is that something for yours or is it the auditors or?
That would be me in the assessor's office. So.
But my question was, what do they do if they're like, hey, is the best thing to do is come down and visit you guys, call here or?
Yeah. Anytime they call us, because we aim for accuracy here. You know, we want to be the, so we track permits, whether they're demo permits or building permits, we help track those. Anytime people call us or come in and say they've removed something, we want to go out and check and get that off your assessment. So our assessment date is January 1st. So it's how the property set on January 1st. So if you tear down your shed in February or July, it's not coming off until the next year. Okay.
Makes sense.
January 1st. Okay.
Right. So we sent a form 11 annually. You got yours in April, probably a yellow form, right? Told your next year's assessment.
Yep.
So that's another way that we try to communicate with the taxpayer. If they have a question, they need to review that. That was on my list of another mistake is people just get that form and toss it to the side. A lot of people, you need to review it and come see us to check for accuracy. That's, and so if there is a problem or you disagree with that value, you have until June 15th to file an appeal for us to come out to your property and take a look at that.
That's good to know. Okay. Yeah. And then people ask, we're lending money, right? We're doing mortgages for people thinking about buying homes a lot. And they're like, well, it's assessed for this much money. And, you know, we always tell them like, look, the assessed value is not necessarily the appraised value. And I was told a long time ago, tell me if this is true or not, that the assessed values come from trending data from possibly a couple years back. Like how new is the assessed values?
So we track every deed in Howard County comes through our office and we do track all sales. So for example, we track every sale from January 1st of 2021 through December 31st of 2021. And we use that data comparing the AV to the sales prices. And we do a trending factor based on that ratio study. And that's what you see on that yellow form we mail out to see that your neighborhood might be trending up or down based on the sales. Does that make sense?
Yeah. So this year's value then, so like my current assessed value is from last year's data?
Is the yellow form you just got. So it's going to be next year's taxes.
Okay.
Right. So your assessment on January 1st of 2022, your taxes are not due until 2023, but the data is from 2021. Yes.
Okay. So it's newer than I realized,
mm-hmm.
which is good because, you know, we all know values are going up and up and up, which tells me that next year I'm probably going to get taxed at a higher assessed value.
Right.
Okay. So we're about a year behind in our data.
Yeah. I was surprised this year. I did the study that there were a couple neighborhoods that stayed the same, but generally speaking, most everybody went up. And you know, you guys see the market. So,
right. And it's the same thing we hear it on our side, you know, that, and people complain because they have to pay taxes. It's just one of the things, but it's not bad, right? I mean, it's actually nice when your assessed value is increasing, your value is increasing. It's an investment. It's just one of the things that. But it's good, right? It helps all that money goes to a lot of it goes right back into the community. For
absolutely. Right. Stuff up, so. Supporting all the taxing units, schools and sheriff's department, all those tax units.
Now, do you use, how do you know when someone makes changes to their property, they don't do a building permit and they go build a 30 by 30 pole barn out back? How do you guys know that? You have satellite spies or spies out there watching this?
No, there's a few things. Like I said, we do track permits, building and demo permits. And when we do the sales, when the sales data comes in, we go out and do a, what's called a sale verification on all valid sales. And so we go out and drive by those properties to make sure what we're, what sold is what we have it assessed for. You know, we look and see that that house, we get that data that it has, we can read, you know, this is 4-bedroom, 2-bath house and it's got a finished basement. And maybe we didn't have the finished basement. And we drive by and see if the shed's still there or the pool. That's one way. And we can pick up a lot of data as we're driving around and see that, see changes. If we see something else going on, we'll mark it down and track that. And also reassessment goes on and we do a quarter of the county every year. So we walk by every property at least once every 4 years.
Oh, wow.
So right now we're doing City North. Last year was Eastern. So we do City North of Markland this year. Next year will be in the city limits south of Markland. The third year is Western Howard County. And then we do Eastern Howard County. And it just rotates. So we walk by every property at least once every 4 years.
So somebody's walking by and just observing, right? I mean, are you going onto the property or?
We print a card. So we have stacks of paperwork, a property record card. Yeah. And they have a stack and then we have it routed in the most efficient way. And yeah, he walks around the property and makes sure what we have is accurate data.
Interesting.
They're not going in your house and knocking on your door. He's just saying, yes, right. Brick house and it has only one shed, you know.
Right. He's not in one of those like white vans that didn't have any windows on it or anything where he just creeps
no.
down.
No, and I have a list of every vehicle that they drive so I can keep a record. And they all have a vest that say assessor on the back.
Yeah.
So, and now with cameras, you know, a lot of times people didn't realize they were getting, guys were out doing assessment, but now with everybody having a camera, they're like, oh, somebody was on my property. So
right.
they do knock on the door first and then he'll turn his back to show the camera that he's the assessor before he walks around.
Right.
Measurements.
So that's good. That's awesome. Like I didn't realize it was that frequent on the reassessment. So
yeah,
that's good. That's impressive because that's a lot of properties to cover.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So no satellite. You're not using satellite imagery.
We have aerial photography. We get that done about every 3 years. We get new flights. That's what you see on Beacon. Have you been to our Beacon website?
Yeah,
all the time.
Yep. So, excuse me. That we have those flown about, like I said, every 3 years. It's a 3-year cycle.
Okay.
So we actually have a project with that too, but it's if we get time, where it's called Change Finder. Well, it'll compare the image, from the old photography to the new one. And if it sees a new structure or a missing structure, it'll print us a list.
Oh, so it's computerized. So it just catches. That's interesting.
Yep.
Huh. How many people do you have in your department?
Right now I have 4 full-time people and 1 part-timer in my office. And then there's a center township assessor and she has 2 full-time employees as well. Huh. And then I have a contractor, Ad Valorem Solutions. They're the one who does our reassessment. They're the guys walking around.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Well, that's pretty neat. I've actually learned some stuff I wasn't sure about. People ask us all the time, just, you know, it comes up when people are talking about financing and what to expect and if taxes are going to change. And
right.
So it's just, it's good for us to fully understand how it works.
And other facts is people may not know is like we have like 18 townships in Howard County and everyone don't have the same tax rate. Irvin is different than Taylor Kokomo.
Okay.
And so that impacts your taxes as well.
Good point. So it's cheaper in the county, right? Versus living in the city. Same home, same features is going to be a lot less.
Depending on your township. Yep. Hmm. It can be different. Mm-hmm. Like I said, we just go, my goal is just accuracy, trying to track data. We're not trying to, you know, hurt anybody specifically. We just want to be fair and equitable across the board.
Right. So and that's really what it's all about. Everybody's it is what it is, right? Like you said before, it's all going for the betterment of our community and you just got to make sure everything's accurate. And if it's not, then you guys want to adjust it.
Yeah.
As well as the consumer to make sure it's accurate.
Right. And so So if somebody sees just a problem and we've made a mistake, we'll just get that changed for you. But if there's just a disagreement on like the Form 11 that just came out and you just disagree that the value's wrong, it just, my property isn't worth that, or it's worth more than that even, we'd get those. You know, the first meeting we have, I do. It's an informal. One of our representatives will come out and meet with you, go over the card, make sure it's accurate. And then hopefully we'll come to an agreement. If not, then we have what's called a PETA bill board. And then you'll go to this hearing. We got five board members and you present your case to them and they will weigh and see what to do. Huh. Change needed.
Right. But it's nice that it goes to a board, because then you've got more than one person that you're just presenting it to.
Right. Right.
So people actually contact you to argue that their house is worth more than you're taxing them at.
Yep. I love it. It's not as common, but we have had that.
Yes. Yeah, the principle of the thing. Too right. Funny. Well, hey, Steve, you got any other questions?
No, I think that was for right now, but I know it'll probably spur some more stuff. So
right,
that's good. But before we say bye to you, Mindy, thanks so much for just spending a little bit of time with us. I'm sure, because it's the same thing, we're going to ask some people to like leave some comments down below. And then if something pops up, we'll make sure you get those to try to get some answers out to everybody on it. So if you liked it, share the video, comment on it, and then we can get Mindy back over here to be able to answer some questions for everybody.
Absolutely.
Okay. Thanks for being on.
Thank you.
All right. So next week, we're going to be interviewing Julie Borden. She's at FC Tucker Miles Realty. She's going to be talking about Florida real estate market. What to expect if you're thinking about buying a home in Florida, the Airbnb strategies, oceanfront versus inland, all this and more. Be sure to join us next Tuesday at noon.